Are you familiar with this channel right here by Brian Dean, Backlinko? If you're not, you should be if you have a website. In fact, it's one of my favorite channels and probably one of the YouTube, I actually don't even talk about other YouTube channels that much, but this is the one that I think I get the most value out of. He doesn't put out a lot of videos, but when he does, there's some valuable information in there. Today, he released a video, my 15 all-time best SEO tips, and this is going to be kind of a piggyback video. So he's saying his tips in this video, and in my video right now, I'm going to go through those tips, and specifically the ones that have to do with WordPress, I'm going to show you how to implement inside of WordPress. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com. This is my channel right here. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button, join 50,000 other people, subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell if you'd like to not miss a thing. I release a ton of content related to WordPress. And so we're gonna go through Brian Dean's video right now and how to implement it in WordPress. It's going to be kind of a down and dirty, just getting it done type of video, not much fluff. So here is the list of the 15 items to get the SEO tips. They're all right here. Now, I'm not in any way saying don't watch Brian's video. As a matter of fact, if you haven't seen Brian, if you're familiar with my channel and you're seeing this before you saw his video, go and watch his video and then this will make sense to you. So what I'm going to do though is I'll put in the video description box, I'll put a link to Brian's channel and also a link to his video. Yes, I'm promoting someone else that I've never even talked to, but I just appreciate what he's doing so much. And so let's just go through these. So the very first item, the very top tip, the very first tip is short URLs rank better in Google. So if you put up a new blog post or a new page, you have your domain name and then that other part of it is the full URL that takes you there. And a shorter URL ranks better in Google. And as a matter of fact, I have been implementing this because I think he might have said this in the past and I am doing that now. Now by default, what WordPress does is when you put a title in, it's gonna take that title and it's gonna use all of it. Sometimes it'll strip out it or a or the, and it will use that for the URL. But then you can actually go in there and make it say exactly what you want it to say. Let me give you an example. So I'm in WordPress, I'm gonna go to posts, I'm gonna click on add new, and we're gonna add a new post. So what I'll do is I'll put a title in here and you can see for yourself what WordPress does, and then I'm gonna show you how to change it. Okay, so I put a title here that says 5 ways to optimize your blog's SEO. I actually haven't changed my permalinks. That should have been the first thing. This is just a demo site. So you can see what the URL is generated. I've got my domain name, and then right here it says 5 ways to optimize your blog's SEO. That would be a long link, and what we want is a shorter link which will rank better with Google. So what you can do is click on this little edit here and type whatever you want. So for me, this is what I might put. So I changed the text to just say blog SEO like that. Now keep in mind, each page and post can have that one URL, that one full URL, but you can only use that one time for that one page or post. So just keep that in mind when you are choosing to shorten it. So you can see this is a lot shorter. And if I had my permalinks set properly, which I'm gonna do right now, it will be even shorter. So a good best practice, if you're not familiar, you always want to, first thing you do with WordPress is you wanna go in here, set your permalink underneath settings, permalink to post name, just like this. Click on save changes. I probably should have done that before starting this video, but this is just a test website that I'm going through right here. So now let's see what that URL looks like. And it's right here, the domain name and then slash blog SEO. And so the point of the first tip is that a shorter URL is going to rank better in Google. You're primarily going to want to put your keywords keywords in there, but not like 15 keywords. Just try to keep it down to 2 or 3 keywords. If you go to my website and look at any of the blog posts, you're gonna see that I've been following this lately. Okay, so the tips that don't relate to WordPress, I'm gonna read them real quick. If there's something that might be WordPress related, I will talk about it, and there's a couple asterisks here. Those are definitely WordPress related. Second tip was to use Amazon for keyword research. Basically going into books on Amazon and then in your niche and then look at the table of contents. I thought that was brilliant because what happens is we get in this thing called an echo chamber. And so whatever your website's about, you're in this echo chamber, and it's sometimes hard to connect with what someone else might want to know about what your topic or your niche is. And so this trick right here, which I do think is pretty brilliant, is a great way of getting out of that echo chamber to see what people think of with your niche and what kind of questions they might ask. Okay, number 3, optimize your title for click-through, CTR, click-through, and SEO. Click-through rate is a ranking signal. So basically, we already should be knowing that we need to write our titles for SEO, but what's actually, I think, might even be maybe even more important is click-through rate. So essentially, we have this double problem, right? We've got to write a title that is going to have our keywords in it and is going to hopefully show on Google, but if Google's showing it on the link to your page on the first page of Google and it's showing it there, but nobody's actually clicking on it, guess what? That's gonna be a signal to Google to start lowering the ranking of that page. So you have to write your titles in a way to be enticing to get that click-through rate. Here's something that you can do with your website. You should have an SEO plugin. I've always used Yoast, but there's others out there like All-in-One SEO. So I'm not saying one tool's better than the other, but I do have Yoast on here. Yoast is what I'm most familiar with, and Yoast is what I use. So if you have Yoast installed and you're on a blog post like this, you scroll down, you have the Yoast options box right here. So right here is what the snippet preview is of what it would look like if Google was showing a link to this particular blog post. So you can go right here, click on edit snippet, change that title. Whatever you put right here will actually be the title that shows when someone's looking at this in Google. And the same thing here for your meta description. That's this little bit here. You put something in there that's going to entice someone to click. Okay, it's super important. Both of those go together, the click-through rate and SEO. All right, so that's that. Okay, number 4, and this is something I struggle with personally, but I am working on. Publish content greater than 1,890 words. And you might ask yourself, how the heck did he come up? That's such a crazy number. How did he come up with that? And I was initially thinking of that. And then 5 seconds later, he said they've done all the tests and the studies and the averages and all that. And there was this nice little chart he showed about how many words and the likeliness of it ranking better. And that was pretty much the sweet spot. So most of us will go ahead and we'll write something and it might be 300 or 500 or 600 words. If you really want to do well with your content, it needs to kind of hit that mark. Of course, you can go under. It's probably not a hard and fast rule, but just so you know, with WordPress, when you are typing out a blog post, there is a word count here on the bottom left, and that's how you're going to know if you're approaching that number of 1,890. It's kind of funny. You put a wacky number like that, it's going to be definitely more memorable. That's how come I actually remember it. Okay, number 5, use title tag modifiers like the current year, best review, free shipping checklist. So these are words you're going to add to whatever your keyword may be at the end. So best whatever review or whatever, 2018 or whatever, something along those lines. That's what he's talking about in number 5. Number 6, use keyword rich URLs. And so this goes back to the first point of using a short URL. If you're going to choose what to put in there, you're going to want your keywords in there for sure. And you don't have to have the longer versions of your keyword phrases. I would definitely keep it very short and tidy. Okay, so that was Let's see, I'm going to lose track here. Okay, we're on number 7. Use numbers in your title. This is actually something that I haven't tried really. It says use numbers in your title to boost click-through rate. Titles with numbers get more clicks. I want to test that, but you know, I could see how I might be more inclined to click on a link that has a number in it, and the studies probably are not lying there. Number 8, use a two-step email outreach to build backlinks. About 2 months ago, I did a review of a product that is on AppSumo It was called Lemlist, and it was a cold outreach tool. And so essentially, you need to, or you will want to be building inbound links. And it's not an easy thing. You can't go out and buy some links or pay someone for links. You have to put in the legwork of reaching out to other websites that would have something to gain from linking to your website or referencing your content. So that is number 8. I gotta say, that is the one thing that you hear Neil Patel, that's another YouTube channel that you should check out. Neil Patel always harps down on this, and I think this is the tip that separates people, because it's the one that requires legwork and you've really got to put yourself out there. So I think the people that are doing this are the ones that get the greatest reward. Okay, broken link building. This is an interesting strategy. It involves finding websites that you would want to link from, finding broken links on their website, and then contacting them, cold contacting them and letting them know about it and asking if they would be interested in pointing a link back to you. Number 10, choose keywords with strong commercial intent. This is actually just a really good SEO best practice of choosing keywords. He gives a great example of someone that a commercial intent is someone that's searching for free yoga videos is different from someone that is searching best yoga training courses or online courses. So there's a commercial intent there. But that all depends on what your blog's about and what your goal is with a particular blog post. So that one is definitely depends. Okay. Number 11, delete underperforming pages. Having excess pages on a site is bad for SEO. And I added this myself, zombie pages. And that's actually a phrase I got from one of his earlier videos that you should definitely check out. I'll also link to that in the video. Man, I'm going to be giving this guy all these video links, but that's all right, because I think it's going to be good for you. Okay, so this is, he even prefaced it as a little controversial, and that is deleting content that no one really goes to anyway. So this means you should know kind of some analytics on how your different pages on your website are performing so that you can know which ones that, you know, there's no value really being added there. And there's some info that he cited from some studies that, and also some info from Google to support why you're going to want to delete underperforming pages. So what you want to do, you have to be a little careful when you delete stuff in WordPress, because Google already will probably know about that page. You delete it, and now Google's going to look at your website and say, what happened to this page? So you need to have something called a redirect. And that is whenever you delete a piece of content, you can redirect anyone that visits that link someplace else on your website. So you got to have your redirects dialed in. I use the paid version of Yoast because it automatically does that. So if I go ahead and delete content, it will redirect it or propose a redirection for me. And then there's a whole bit that it manages. It's definitely not crucial. There are plenty of redirect plugins in the WordPress repository. A lot of great redirect plugins that you can use where you can manually go in and create that redirect. Actually, I should be showing you how to do that in this video, but I didn't even think about that in advance. You definitely want to have those redirects in place. Maybe I will have a separate video after this about just a general video about redirects and how to put those together. It's super easy. But what I wanted to talk about was something called zombie pages. So in a prior video he made earlier this year, he talked about how one of his customers or followers had their website and Google was indexing 60,000 pages from their website, and they reduced that down to, I think it was like 10,000 pages, and all of their rankings just went through the roof. So that was basically accomplish through deleting what he referred to as zombie pages. And I remember when I saw that video, I'm like, oh my gosh, I need to figure out how to get rid of these zombie pages because I'm probably suffering from the same thing. So these are pages that with WordPress are kind of automatically generated and they provide little to no value, and you can very easily get rid of these zombie pages. Let me show you. So if you're using Yoast, I can't show you for all-in-one SEO because I don't use it, but it's probably just as easy. And I'm sure you can figure it out. So if you go into Yoast, go right here to search appearance, you have these tabs here. One of them is taxonomies. And so when you click on taxonomies, these are basically if you have a category on your website, WordPress generates a page for that. If you have tags for every single tag, WordPress generates a page for it. And not only is it one page, if you have lots of content on that tag or that category, there's that pagination. So there's page one, page two, page three. If you have a lot of tags and a lot of categories, this can easily equal thousands of pieces of content that Google's indexing that are very low value. So what I did is I came into Yoast and I clicked on taxonomies, and I still wanted my category pages. I wasn't ready to get rid of that, but for tags, I was ready to get rid of that. And so essentially what you could do is you can come in here. This is set to yes. If you set it to no, you can click on this check this question mark to find out exactly what this is doing. Essentially, it's telling Google to not index these tag pages, these tag category pages. So that's all that that's doing. So I went ahead and turned that off. And I think I also did the same thing for the archives here because I didn't want that pagination. So let's take a look at the archives right here. So you can turn off author archives, definitely get rid of that. Date archives, I got rid of that. And these, I'm just telling you what I did. I'm not saying you have to do this. And there is some debate whether there is value in having these tag pages. I do know some scenarios where there is value in having them. However, if you're like a full legit website and you want overall good rankings, and maybe there might be a little bit of a competitiveness there, you definitely don't want to have those pages, or you don't need those pages. But it's up to you. Know what you're doing if you disable those. But it doesn't remove them. It just puts instructions when Google comes to your website next to just not index those pages. Okay, so that was number 11 in zombie pages. I just threw that in. Number 12, video SEO. Number 13, use Reddit for keyword research. I've got to get into that myself. Number 14, link out to authority websites. I've actually tested this and it's been really good. So say you, I had a website about voice over IP phones. And so what I did on some of the posts is I would link out to the manufacturers of products or of certain bits of technology, and those pages did a lot better. So you should probably already know how to create an outbound link in your content. So if I go to posts, all posts, and I'll go jump into that same post that I was just in right here, it's super easy to create a link. So you can go ahead and put some text in. So I just put this bit in, says Grandstream Phones. You can highlight it, click right here on the insert link, and then you can go ahead and put your link in there. And then you also get some options here if you want to open link in new tab. I usually have it open in a new tab myself because I don't want people going off of my website. But that's how you would add a link in your content in WordPress. You probably already know this. The last one was hack Wikipedia, look at the table of contents. And that's pretty interesting too. I got to see how I might be able to benefit from that. So anyways, I just wanted to make this quick down and dirty video to go over this. I thought Brian's video was fantastic. All of his videos are fantastic. And I think if he releases another video about SEO, you can expect a video about on this channel about how to implement that in WordPress. So hey, if you have found any value in this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions specific to the content in this video, just ask it down below in the comment section and I'll be very happy to answer it for you. Hey, thank you for watching this video and I'll see you in the next one.